Supply chains are still in total chaos all across the United States, and now American consumers are being warned about coming shortages ahead of the busy holiday season. Several business owners, big retailers, and even the Vice President of the United States have been alerting that store shelves may soon be empty as the global shipping crisis aggravates. They've been asking people to prepare for further supply chain disruptions and start placing their Christmas orders as soon as possible if they want to get them in time. In short, we're about to witness another turbulent shopping season as the supply chain crisis rapidly spirals out of control. A wide range of factors, including a shortage of shipping containers, record high consumer demand, port congestion, and soaring freight costs, have all conspired against global supply chains and businesses that have been waiting for their orders to arrive for months. This literally is the perfect storm, stressed Kevin Brady, managing director at Woodland Groups, in a recent interview. There have been many factors, but it all started with the health crisis, and effectively then it was just a domino effect, he said. There's just too much demand for vessels, while infrastructure at ports is creaking as a result, causing prolonged delays. There's a record-breaking number of cargo ships currently stuck at California ports. About a month ago, 44 ships were stuck outside the ports of Los Angeles and Long Beach, and up until that point, that had been the highest number of ships waiting to unload on California docks. But things have escalated very quickly. From 44, we now have 65 ships queuing outside the two biggest ports in America. And that's a signal of how severe port congestion has become across the United States ports. The two ports handle more than 40% of all cargo containers entering the country. But before the onset of the health crisis, it was unusual for more than one to wait for a berth. Now that consumers are aware of the imminent shortages and retailers and manufacturers have been rushing to place orders to restock their inventories before the holiday season, the global shipping system is struggling to keep up. Experts say that disruptions to shipping are expected to last way beyond Christmas. According to Gene Soroka, head of the Port of L.A., the staggering volume of cargo arriving at California ports right now could mean that congestion won't start to ease until the second half of 2022. We continue to monitor a host of variables. Disruptions continue at every node in the supply chain, he revealed. The L.A. and Long Beach ports are the main seaborne gateway to the country, especially for imports coming from China. Over the weekend, a record 73 ships were waiting for a berth, nearly twice as many as at the same time in August. Many cargo ships have been diverted to other ports because of the unprecedented backlog. However, the situation has only gotten worse since most nearby ports don't have enough capacity to deal with the volume of trade, which is preventing thousands of containers from being unloaded. Only this year, the Port of L.A. alone has seen the amount of cargo normally handled increasing by 30%. Currently, congestion is related to cargo moving from the port, such as trucks and freight rail, due to record-high cargo volume, explained spokeswoman Amanda Kwan in an interview with the BBC. Some executives argue the real problem is that American businesses are panic buying goods they don't actually need. Consequently, that is overwhelming already stressed supply chains and significantly worsening the global shipping crisis. One Asia-based supply chain veteran, who preferred to speak on condition of anonymity, said, "If there were real shortages, how come every warehouse in the U.S. is full to the rafters? Panicked overbuying, questionable forward sales predictions, and weak, none-too-transparent procurement systems among American shippers are in fact the greatest reasons for this year's supply chain disaster," he told Splash. On the same note, Bjorn Fang Jensen, the vice president at consultancy Sea Intelligence, also cites factors such as panic buying and extremely inaccurate sales forecasts as the main catalyst of the global supply chain meltdown. but the executive highlights that these issues have always existed. In the past, almost any supply chain has been able to roll with such punches, which are now mostly forgotten as minor blips in a dusty data set, Jensen explains. What you see today is not only a black swan event, but in fact, an entire bevy of black swans, and one which grows larger by the day, as more and more weak strands in the supply web snap, he added. Across all global markets, the United States is seen as the real origin of this fiasco. But things are more complicated than they look, and there's an explanation why warehouses are so full. According to a piece of recent Sea Intelligence research, many industries across the country are actually dangerously low on inventory, and one of the main determinants exacerbating supply chain woes is the very real shortage of truck drivers who collect goods from these warehouses to deliver to the stores and, of course, to the consumers. Industry experts outline that ports simply cannot keep up with the pace of growing import demand over a sustained period. Neither can warehouses. Andy Lane from CTI Consultancy, a container advisory, describes that our aging logistics infrastructure and the near impossibility for retailers to have prepared for such a seesaw in demand have contributed to worsening the container crisis. The entire system grinds to somewhat of a halt because it was never going to be capable of absorbing a 20 to 30% or more increase in consumer demand, Lane said. The shippers and importers have tried to import more than their distribution capacity can handle. The carriers have tried to move more demand than they should have known that the ports and land side can accommodate. Adding more floating capacity in container ship is pointless if it creates a bigger gridlock, he emphasized. As a result, we are recording a massive amount of wasted resources. As a complete collective, all supply chain stakeholders have simply ignored constraints and just unintelligently flooded the system to everyone's detriment, Lane points out. So far, from all of the capacity shipped from Asia to the U.S., 24% has been lost to congestion, according to data from Sea Intelligence. On the other hand, some market analysts say U.S. shippers have not been panicking. They've only been trying to meet the increased consumer demand, and they've been tricked by shipping companies. That's what Chris Kosmala, columnist and partner at Advisory Click and Connect, recently affirmed during an interview with Splash. It all went bad with irregular sailings when carriers cut capacity in response to the health crisis, Kosmala maintains. This deprived shippers of the regular services on which they built their supply chain's execution. So they ordered more, and those orders accumulated in containers waiting for slots that were not there. That happened long before Maersk went public, obnoxiously advising shippers to double up on inventories and import more just in case, Kosmala adds. Even if the carriers restored the services to 100% right away, it would have taken 2 years to ship all that backlog, mixed with all the regular shipments that were being added at a normal pace, he says. In essence, shipping companies are aware that ports cannot handle the immense cargo volume sent every day. But they have been inciting shippers to order far more than they need to restock their inventories. That, in turn, elevates the demand for cargo shipping and, of course, pushes the profit margins of those shipping companies to sky highs as shipping costs go through the roof. However, skyrocketing shipping and freight prices are preventing small and medium-sized businesses to actually restock their shelves and offer their products. As the holiday season approaches, the United States Toy Association, which represents 950 toy firms with a U.S. presence, has warned about looming shortages, given that their products have been sent to the end of the shipping priority list. While large companies have decades-long relationships with shipping companies, smaller businesses cannot afford to pay a premium for in-time deliveries, it's really the small companies that are facing the brunt of this impact. They really don't have the leverage or the size to have those annual contracts, a spokesman to the association revealed. A family-owned factory in Wauconda, Illinois, that makes gears and pulleys used in a variety of industrial equipment, was forced to halt production because it's become impossible to get all parts needed to assemble its products. I'm getting phone calls of, "Hey, you're holding up a $5 million machine," exposed Nicole Walter, who runs the factory, adding that customers oftentimes offer to pay for overtime in her factory. She says, "I think there's just that air of desperation." The products provided by her company are essential for many other businesses, and the shortage of parts is creating major trouble across the supply chain. "I had an order for a plater that was sitting on their dock for 6 weeks and they hadn't touched it because they couldn't get the workforce," Walter said. "So that hurt." If you ever try to cook a complex dish and realized in the middle of the process that an essential ingredient was missing, then you can understand what manufacturers are wrestling with for the past year and a half. Many are being forced to shut down operations as they wait for key parts to arrive. "You've got 99 of the 100 parts you need, and then you have work in process that's stuck," underscored Tim Fiore, who conducts a monthly survey of factory managers for the Institute for Supply Management. "It's a circus," Walter exclaimed, "and I'd like to get off this ride." Sadly, this crisis is far from over. Industry specialists are warning that prices of several supplies will rise exponentially because of port log jams, and the situation is getting so dire it is expected to last until 2023. According to Jackson Mayer, the chief executive of freight forwarding firm Verus Global, as retailers run to stock up on best-selling items, supply snags, transportation chaos, and inflated prices are about to take this crisis to a whole new level. To make things even worse, the U.S. overall retail supply level has remained at record lows for 4 months in a row. In May, it marked an all-time low in the data going back to 1992. Even though things slightly improved in July, inventory still remained near the lowest levels in the data. And now that store shelves are being wiped out at record speed, those who are planning to buy certain Christmas presents have probably already missed their chance to get them under the tree. According to Mr. Mayer, it's probably too late by now, particularly for items such as furniture, beds, TVs, or anything that has to be imported. At this point, we can only hope that a repeat of last year's panic buying frenzy doesn't occur during the holiday season, but it is safe to say that much more chaos will arise as shortages intensify. Our modern society has never experienced such a devastating collapse on global supply chains, but we're about to find that the stage is set for a meltdown of epic proportions.